If you're looking to build your team, make sure you head on over to cheapmaddencoins.com for the cheapest prices, fast delivery, and 24-hour customer support. And make sure to use code WOLF for 10% off.
Yo, what's up, everybody? It's King Wolf. Welcome to today's video. And today we're going to talk about the new Madden NFL 18 February title update. Now, they did fix one good thing that made me want to make this video because I think it's an important thing. Is the possession catch. But we're going to go ahead and talk about this right now, man. Make sure you drop a like on the video, subscribe to my channel for more content. So, to ensure Madden is the best game possible, title updates are deployed by the Madden development team to add features to the game after launch and to tune gameplay based on community feedback. Here's a detailed breakdown of what's included in the latest title update, now live in Madden 18. So if you haven't played Madden 18 like in a week because you're tired of the game and all the BS, there's an actual update that's live right now that you'll be able to download. I want to say it's like 700 or 800 megabytes as far as the download. I don't know what it is on PS4, but on Xbox, I think it was like 800. Anyway, so gameplay updates, man. Added logic so that the weak box exploit manager does not trigger versus AI-controlled opponents. Penalty results in frequent pancake blocks by the offense. So that's going to be something that I'm going to check out here in a little bit, running dime against a heavy set and see how many pancake blocks are actually taking place. I know they fixed a lot of it, but does this mean that now you can come back to DB fire, you know, out of the dime or the $326 and actually do some work, or are you still going to be penalized for that weak box system that they have in there? I don't know, man. I'm going to check it out, but they did fix something inside of it. The next one is addressed an issue causing QBs with the gunslinger ability to throw touch passes instead of bullet passes. Now, I have a budget team. I don't have QBs that are special as far as chemistry goes, so I can't touch bases there with you guys, but people that have the gunslinger QBs will know more than me. So put in the comments, man, if you see a change in your passes. Next is addressed an issue that would occasionally prevent ball carriers from being tackled directly following a broken tackle animation. Me personally, I have never seen this, but it is an issue and it's a good thing that they did address it. Next is addressed an issue causing defenders to occasionally give up on the play during some broken tackle animations. Now that I have seen, where, you know, whenever you're running back or someone gets past a certain part of the field, everybody gives up. Like, not even certain part of the field, it's actually, you know, where the play is still taking place. Once they break a tackle, you'll notice that the defenders just stand there. They're just standing around. One thing that I did notice as far as this update goes is it kind of messed up playmaker for me personally. My playmakers walk up the field now, bro. Sometimes, not all the time, but I want to say half. It's 50-50 that my playmakers actually walk up the field. So I don't know if it has something to do with the update. I don't know, but I'm going to go ahead and play a couple more games after I make this video and see what's going on. Now, the biggest one, my pet peeve, probably everybody inside Madden, address the jumping sideline catch animation that would often force players to land out of bounds. You know, in the NFL, I have never seen someone bunny hop out of bounds when they catch the ball. Usually, you know, they try to keep 2 feet in. I've never seen someone try to bunny hop their way, you know, in all my life of watching NFL. And they would do that more than not in Madden 18, especially when you had someone wide open and no one was around. They would bunny hop out the sidelines, man, and just making it so frustrating, especially like if you try to throw something like on, you know, 4th and 8 or 4th and 13, you know, you're going for it. And then that guy just bunny hops out. Oh, that's just so frustrating. It makes a lot of people mad, but they did fix that. It's not in the game no more. What I think they did do with the countering, though, is that if you possess and catch it and someone is around you, you're going to drop the ball. So pay attention. Let me know if I'm right about that. Next is added a fix to disable the 10-second runoff when the team is winning, takes a penalty with less than a minute left in the half or game. Well, that's good that they fixed that. Never really ran into that problem yet. But another big one, added fixes to aggressive pass rush to help ensure defenders have a chance to jump off sides no matter what formation the defense comes out in. So if you came out nickel 3-3-5 and had aggressive pass rush and they try to fake hike it, you wouldn't go off sides. Like, none of your guys would go off sides, so you're able to stay on aggressive pass rush. I don't know if a lot of people knew that, but that's why a lot of people run 3-3-5. Now, you're playing with fire there, because in 3-3-5, you know, if someone runs a power O or, you know, some runs, they could probably smack you up if you don't have the right defenders in place to stop the run in that 3-3-5 defense. those are some of the things they fixed. Let's go ahead and just talk about the rest of it, man. Developer note, the weak box exploit manager was introduced this year to encourage players to better match the offensive personnel on the field when trying to defend the run, especially heavy run sets with eight or more run blockers inside the tackle box. Due to a lot of valuable feedback from our players, we discovered the AI could get hit by this inadvertently, which was never the intent of the exploit manager. The new logic will prevent it from occurring when playing AI opponents moving forward. So it's going to be pretty cool to see what's going on with what they're doing here, man. I'm going to run my own little test and see, you know, how the pancake blocks work. Will we be able to come out $326 from now on? I don't know. Probably not. But we'll check it out. In franchise mode, man, they really don't like franchise. I'm going to tell you guys right now. They don't even care. They just a basic, simple bulletin right here. Address stability issues in franchise. Like, no features, no, you know, it doesn't make money, so they're just going to ignore you. I'm sorry, guys, but it's just the way it's going to be from here on out, probably. Unless they do some complete overhaul in Madden 19, which I doubt. Who knows? Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe. Madden Ultimate Team, you'll see that everything they changed here because, you know, it's the moneymaker. Added a new tab called Ultimate League to the Ultimate Team main menu that will be focused on the upcoming Madden Championship Series Ultimate League event. You know, the Championship Series where you see all these pro players run two plays? Yeah, that's what they're fixing right there. Check the viewing schedule and watch live all from this convenient new screen. Also added a new tab called Team Visuals to the Ultimate Team lineup screen that will allow you to choose which head coach and uniforms are brought into game, and allows you to get the chemistry boost from your Zero Chill uniforms equipped on the Team Strategy tab while wearing the Jacksonville's Jaguar Color Rush uniforms equipped on the Team Visuals tab. And then last but not least, address an issue where not all the chemistry boosts were showing up on the lineup screen. All right. So that is the update, man. Let me know what you guys think of the new update. If you notice anything different, what's broken, because you know with these updates, you fix something, you break something else, and I'm actually anxious to see what you guys have seen so far as, you know, something bad. I want to know what's broken now, because that's how it works. It always works this way. They fix something, they break something. You know, it's never just fix it and it's good. Something's going to be broken. Let me know, man. Love you guys, and I will check you guys out in the next one. Peace.